Sometimes it seems to go on a little too long, and you want to like the movie more. And then the movies, we are halfway through going, which one do you like this? You're winning. You're like, ah, I'm nearly there. That's right, but not quite. But the one person who stands out is Anwar Amin. If you know James Gunn, he's the lead of this film. Kid Up Person's been in, The Bill, Sense8, and also The Maze Runner. He is such a talent. And I promise you, he's going to go on to bigger things, and him getting a proper big role here is great. Awesome foodie, Stephen Graham, and a variety of slightly dodgy accents. Not many names.
It was a little bit more, say, Sebastian the Crab than like actual Jamaica. But that was still a good film. Me and Anthony enjoyed it.
Look. If you ask me to do an accent, get an accent now, it would not. It would not go well. It's a tough one.
I think a little bit of work. It's sometimes difficult.
You can't hear it straight away.
Yeah.
How many points are
you? I'm going to give it 3. I'm being generous.
Cheesy puns?
No.
Regular puns?
Regular puns. Alright, another
thing. You need it?
So, see you later, puns. The Spy Who Dumped Me is a totally different film, but I also want to talk about it. It stars Mila Kunis, who's the best, and Kate McKinnon, who's also the best, and Gillian Anderson, who's the best. That's a good name for this film.
That's Kate McKinnon on Saturday Night Live and stuff.
Yes, also in Ghostbusters, the reboot we did it. This film made no sense. Obviously, the plot's pretty simple to begin with. Mila Kunis has been going out. She had no idea. They wake up, she doesn't know why. It turns out, because he's a spy, and she's like, let's get into trouble, let's go. Anyway, Mila Kunis and Kate McKinnon get involved in his spy-like world, and it's a twisty, very silly, capable